Welcome to Electra Online. One of the specifications of a car battery is the cold cranking amps. Let's say you go to the store and they advertise that this particular battery gives you 400 cold cranking amps. What does that really mean, and is that really important to you? Well, it depends where you live. If you live in a warm place, you probably don't really care about that. But if you live in a place where it can get quite cold, down to 0 degrees Fahrenheit or even colder than that, it becomes quite important, because the ability for a battery to deliver a current, especially a high current, in order to start your car depends a lot upon the temperature of the battery. In cold temperatures, the chemical process in the battery doesn't work as well, and the battery has trouble providing the necessary current to start a car. And at the point where you start a car, you need a lot of current. That's usually where the battery begins to fail. You turn your key and the car doesn't start because the battery is no longer able to produce enough current to get the starter to turn around the engine, to turn over the engine, as we call it, and get the engine started. So here we have a schematic of that. Let's say that under normal warm conditions, the battery provides, let's say, 600, well, it wouldn't then be cold cranking amps, it would be cranking amps, because it wouldn't be cold at 40 degrees, for example. But then as the temperature gets colder and the battery begins to reduce in temperature, the chemical process is not as efficient, doesn't work as well, and the amount of current that can be produced begins to get less and less and less. Eventually, the definition says that if you get all the way down to 0 degrees Fahrenheit, what will be the ability of the battery to produce a current? And that will then be considered the cold cranking amps. The amount of charge per unit time the battery can produce, the amount of current a battery can produce, is called the cold cranking amps when the temperature is down to 0 degrees Fahrenheit. So at about minus 20, close to about minus 18 degrees centigrade, what will be the current produced by the battery? This will then be considered the cold cranking amps. And your question is that enough to start the car? If it is, you're in good shape. If it isn't, then of course you won't be able to start the car when it gets to be that cold. Now, the older the battery gets and the worse shape the battery gets in, the lower this number will go as well. So new batteries are performing at their rating, but older batteries will actually drop in their ability to produce these kind of things. So for a reasonably new battery of brand new or a few years old, you should be able to get enough cold cranking amps to start the car even in cold conditions. Now, if you live in very cold places, this number becomes extremely important if you want to be able to start your car when it's really cold. And the bigger the cold cranking amps, the better, because at even lower temperatures, that number continues to decline. So even if it's rated at 400, but now it's 40 below, it's now going to give you 400, so you still want to be able to start your car. So you want to start with a higher base current at the high cranking amps before it gets cold. Again, that's what we mean by cold cranking amps. And depending upon where you live, you need to pay attention to that.